ball, possibly in 5 seconds, but within 50 years, do yourself a bit of sleep. Those are words to frighten children. However, your death is not necessarily the only answer to the second item. Would your only activity be that to prepare the excitement for the future? And need that done on time.
I have adopted a new definition of classification, which enables me to regard the whole universe as a class and thus to dispense with the very awkward phrasal set of things. To you how? In the chapter on propositions of existence, I have adopted a new normal form in which the class, whose existence is a firm coordinate, is regarded as the predicate, instead of the subject, of the proposition. Thus, creating a very subtle difficulty which besets the other whole. These subtle difficulties seem to lie at the root of every tree of knowledge, and they are far more hopeless to grapple with than any that occur in its higher branches. For example, the difficulties of the 47th proposition of Euclid are mere child's play compared with the mental torture entered in the effort to think of the essential nature of a straight line. And, in the present world, the difficulties of the Myers problem, at King Light, are 3 bells, light as air, compared with the wildering question what is a thing. In the chapter on propositions of relation, I have inserted a new section, containing the proof that a proposition, beginning with all, is a double proposition, a fact that is quite independent of the arbitrary order. We found in the next section that such a proposition is to be understood as indeed the actual existence of its subject. This book was written in the earlier editions, incidentally, in the course of the discussion of the limits of my graph.
Most interesting mental revelation. Is there an excellent opportunity to adopt the following?